Hello and welcome to this edition of Stay Fit with CNBC TV 18. This is Shivani Gharat and I'm at Aquacentric Center at Andheri in Mumbai. Well, Aquacentric is all about aquatherapy, and at this 7,000 square feet space, all they do is use properties of water for your rehabilitation. So let's find out what this place is all about. Okay, so as I enter, I can see three pools over here. This is the first one, this is the second pool, and there is another pool over here. And in fact, the most interesting part is that I can see an underwater treadmill in this pool along with a camera right there. Well, the whole idea of Aquacentric came thinking that they wanted to set up a center. In fact, Dr. Amit Kohli and Marico's Harsh Mariwala wanted to set up a center to help patients with physical ailments in a very effortless kind of a way. So I'm going to get into this pool. Let me go and change first. So finally, I'm inside the pool and I'm going to try out this underwater treadmill. And to help me, I have Dr. Shilpi with me today.
Hello.
Welcome to Stay Fit with CNBC TV 18. So how does this work really?
So this is an inbuilt underwater treadmill. This treadmill helps us treat clients in water. We do balance training, we do gait training. When I say gait training, it means we help people to walk in a particular manner, which is a reciprocal gait, which is what we want to enhance and get a proper gait pattern, a proper walking pattern.
Sure. Awesome. So I'm a runner. I'm going to try this out and I'm going to understand what is the difference between, let's say, running on land and running in water.
Oh, it's a whole lot of difference that we see here. Here we have added an element of water. So water in itself has three components. It has hydrostatic pressure, it has buoyancy, and it has got viscosity. So all these properties add value to your exercise.
There is something to stop and start the device like any usual treadmill that you find in your gym. And also there is something to manage your pace. So there is a fast button that I can see and there is a slow button. Along with that, there is something over here, there are buttons over here to control pressure of water. So we're going to try that out later on. But let's just first begin with your regular treadmill run right on this inbuilt underwater treadmill. So let's go.
Sure. For that, you need to put your feet on the white strips.
Okay.
And I'm going to start it now. And as and when the strip starts, you have to slowly get onto it.
I'm running in water.
Now what you can see when you are running on this, you have to make your muscles act more because you're going back. So you have to keep balancing yourself. So you're doing your gait training as well as you're doing your balance activity. You're activating your core muscles. So it's a strength training as well along with your gait training.
Okay. All right. This was fun. Now this is a workout where you're running or walking underwater, and I can understand that it will help a lot of patients with any knee injuries or something. But there was another water pressure thing that I saw over there. How does that work?
So this is even more challenging. So with this, when we add this, you have current coming from front and you have to maintain your balance and you have to run against it. So it's a kind of resistance training that we are adding on to your gait training.
Can I try that out?
Sure. Now as you can see, there's water coming, current coming, and we can increase it as well. So this goes up to 99 here.
If I just move my hand, the first thing is if I move my hand in air versus if I move my hand in water, it's 600 to 700 times more resistance. So you strengthen up your muscles directly there. If my weight is say 100 kgs and I'm walking on land, I'm putting 100 kgs pressure on my joints. But the same if my water is at the level of my shoulder, then I'm only putting 1/10, that is only 10 kgs weight on the joints. We have warm pulls, so it helps to kind of, helps to loosen the muscles. So our youngest member is 7 months baby. We have some real complicated cases. So we've had patients coming from Ghana who was adjusted for surgeries, and they have got rehabilitated and gone back home. We've got a patient, client who's has come down from Australia, and he's had 3 major surgeries on the back, and he didn't have control over his trunk. It was just falling off, and we are around about a month and a half to 2 months into our rehab, and he's only walking with one crutch.